Am I audible? Visible? How is it? Are you guys able to hear me out? I see a lot of young guys, young kids, young chaps. Parth, Chaitanya, nice. Anshi, Bhavi, Arav, so many young chaps. Awesome. Very nice. Great. So, can you type in if I'm audible for all of you? Yeah. Yes, great. Path says yes. Awesome. That's nice. So since so many of you are here, who are like, Okay. Kritika wants to say some prayer. Okay. Kritika, let's do it afterwards. No, let's focus about the agenda of today. Great. Now, you know my name. My name is Sudhir Kovi. You must have, read on the pamphlet which you got. So today we are going to talk something very, very unique, amazing, and magical. How many of you would like to know more about your own self from your handwriting and from your signatures? How many of you? If you want to know the way to know about yourself from handwriting, just type in HND hand in the comment box. Type in HND hand if you are interested in learning. Wow, Parthi is interested, Prachi is interested, Meena is interested, awesome, very nice. Oppo, Kuljeet, Bhavya, great. So many young and enthusiastic chaps over here. This is great. Okay, so it's weird, right? A lot of people might think, how can a person know about somebody from handwriting? How can you know about someone else from signature? So this is a question for all of you. How many of you think that you think from brain? How many of you think that you think from brain? How many? Just type B if you think that you think from brain. If you think that you think from brain, just type in B. Let me see how many of you have brain and who think from a brain. Chaitanya, Arav, Malini, Parth, Ravi Shankar, okay, Arav. So many people feel that they think from brain. And how many of you believe that you think from mind? How many of you believe that you think from mind? Can you type in mind if you feel? Okay. So now we have competition. Few are there for brain and few are there for mind. Now this is confusing, right? This is confusing. What is mind? What is brain? A lot of people might be thinking, okay, both are the same. How many of you think that mind and brain are the same? How many of you believe that mind and brain are the same? Same? Okay. Parth same, Bhavya same. Okay. Rishabh also thinks it's the same. Now this is something unique, So for your own awareness, your mind is software. Your mind is software. This is brain. The software is something which you cannot see. It's coded, and the brain is a hardware. And you know how your computer operates, right? Your software gives instruction to the hardware and hardware functions. So your monitor, your mobile is a hardware, but the operating system which works inside, which does actual work, is the software. So similarly, for you, the mind is the software and your body, your brain is the hardware. And in the mind is you cannot see because your mind is not in your body. Your mind is not in your body. Your body is inside your mind. Okay, so your body is inside your mind. So your mind gives instructions to the body and body functions. That is why when you think, there are a lot of thinking going on in your brain, in your mind. You think in your mind and that thinking goes to your brain and brain that generates electromechanical current, which when travels to your hand, comes onto the paper in the form of line, loop, and curve. On the paper, it comes from in the form of line, loop, and curve. Thinking comes from the mind, yeah. And this line, loop, and curve is called as graph. And when we study these things, it's called as graphology. And that is how we come to know about how exactly you are thinking. What is your thinking pattern? Okay, what is the, in your brain, everybody has got brain, right? You all have got brain, yeah? Aruha has also got brain, very nice, very nice. So, in your brain, Aruha, which organ of your body has got maximum space? Aapke dimag mein, aapki kaun se body ke organ ko sabse zyada jagah di gayi? Which organ your body? Just type in, you know, whatever organ you have. Legs, hand, face, eyes, which one? Skin. Aru says skin. Okay. Interesting. Skull is not, okay, skull is not an organ. Skull is bone structure. Okay. Mind is not a physical thing. It's not an organ. Now it's a part of brain. Bones are not the organ. Brain is, okay. Somebody saying eyes, okay, stomach, legs, you are getting close. Cerebrum is again, heart, again, okay, okay. So now, this will be amazing fact for you, that your brain has got, your tongue has got maximum space in your brain. You know, you do so many things with your tongue. You movement, 360 degree movement, you talk, you can utter things, you can chew, you can clean your teeth, you know, so many functions. So when you have so many nerves allocated to the tongue, then only you can do so many functions with the tongue, right? So your brain has got maximum space allocated to your tongue. And after that, your limbs, your hands. And after hands, your fingers. In fingers, thumb has got the maximum space. And that is why when you write, it reveals so much about you. When you write, it reveals so much about yourself. So now, there are two, that is why the writing is known as psychoneuromuscular activity. Psycho means mind, neuro means brain, and muscular means muscles. So many things are involved while writing. That is why writing shows so many things to you. Okay, so now if I ask you this question, how many types of actions are there which your body performs? How many types of action your body performs? Do you know how many types? Do you know about something called as reflex action? What is a reflex action? If you touch to a hot pan, hot thing or hot water, what happens to your hand? You just lift it, no? Without being aware. Are you guys getting it? Without, when you touch a hot thing, you just lift your, without, yeah, automatically lift it. Yeah, Danisha. Without you being aware, you do it. So this is called as reflex action. When you fall down, you try to balance yourself. When you are falling in your dreams, you try to balance your body. That is the stimulus. That is the reflex action. You do it without you being aware. Right? When somebody tries to hit you, you try to save yourself. That is the action of reflex without being aware. So that is a reflex action. The second level of action is voluntary action. You walk, you run, you jump by choice. Yeah, very nice. So voluntary action. So you do some things by choice. Now let's assume you are walking. So walking is a voluntary action. But while walking, your head goes like this, your hand moves like this. So these actions are what? These actions are involuntary actions. So when you write, writing is the voluntary action. So you write A. So the way A comes onto the paper is the voluntary action. But the way your A is going to come onto the paper is involuntary action. So A, see here the A is squeezed, here the A is stretched, and here the A is roundish. Okay. So the roundish A, stretched A, and squeezed A. These are three different types of A's. They come onto the paper without you being aware. So this is an involuntary action. So writing is an involuntary action. Whatever comes onto the paper will reveal so much information about you because it's an involuntary action. Okay. Great. So who, I think Bhavya wants to ask some questions. Let me, Bhavisha Hirani. I will just handle one question before we go forward. Okay. Yeah. Bhavisha, you want to ask some this question? Are you guys getting it? So writing will reveal so much. So today we are going to learn about it. Great. So Bhavya is not asking any question. So how many of you like to hear stories? I'm going to tell you about my own story. Yeah, Bhavya is there. Awesome. Parth also likes. Rishabh also. Awesome. So let me tell you my story, guys. How I started this journey. So, okay, these are my mom and my dad's. My mom and dad used to be a construction worker. You see the people who work on the road construction, they used to do that around 30 years back, you know, 30, 35 years back, they used to do that. And we, you know, it was very struggling time at that time. You know, a lot of people never had the opportunity to earn money because the, you know, revolution was not that great. There were not many opportunities to earn like the way today we see, you know, a lot of food is available, a lot of jobs are available, a lot of money is available. At that time in 1980, 1975, at that time, there was not much of money was there, not much of opportunities were there. So my mother and father both used to just go for construction. They used to earn a small amount and there they used to survive, you know. I don't remember the time when we had a dinner with our mom and dad together, you know. It's like because the food was so limited that if we eat together, nobody will have their stomach full. So they used to allow me and my brother to eat first and then they used to go and eat. So that was the very challenging time. But my father was very visionary. You know, he always thought that I should teach my kids a very good education. You know, they should get good education and all. So he saved money from that time for my education and all. So I never had any complaints about the education fees and everything. But the childhood was very mediocre, never had a lot of, gifts or clothes. You know, we never had the clothes which can fit, you know, fitting wala cloth nahi tha. We used to have this big clothes because that is what we are supposed to wear. So from that background, then, you know, a lot of challenges were there. Father was not having much of the vision, no knowledge. So I always had this struggle of how to grow, how to learn. You know, I went to a lot of people, but those people also were not giving me the knowledge to grow my life. So I struggled, you know, till the age of 22, I guess. So then I also did this software engineering because my father was always pushy and supportive for my education. So I did this software engineering from VJTI Mumbai, which is one of the reputed college, more than 100 years old colleges there. Then in 2006, I learned Graphology. During all those struggling phase, because I was alone, I was aloof, I was not much of the person who used to score good marks. Only one subject I was good at, that is maths. So I was always aloof and alone and nobody would support me. I had no friends. So in truth, I used to pray to the God that God, please help me and give me something because of which I will be a better human being so that people will come and connect with me. People will like me. People will speak with me. You know, I give me friends. That was the calling I had to do. But what happened? Excuse me. So in 2006, my prayers were answered by the God. You know, I got the science of Graphology in my kitty. I started learning this. There I got awareness about what I am, what I can do, what is my potential like, and there I grew in confidence. And thereafter, I see from the, such a humble background, I got a lot of courage because of the graphology, and I took the opportunity, I took the risk, and I then started my own journey as an entrepreneur, a person who will work for himself. Then I did a lot of businesses, but I failed in most of them. You know why? Because I was not suitable for those business. My talent were somewhere else. But because of the pressure, because of the society pressure, I did the conventional business, a traditional business, and I failed miserably. Not that I was not intelligent, not that I was not hardworking, but you know, my unique talents, my unique things were not suitable for that business. So invariably, I failed miserably in those business. And then there was one business where I succeed better, I perform better, but still not as great as I'm doing right now. So what I saw, that graphology changed my life, handwriting and signature changed my life. So I thought, let's do this to other people. Let's teach this science to other people. Let's make them aware about their own potential, own mindset, and let them change their mindset to achieve more in their own life. So there I started teaching graphology in 2018. And from since then, I have grown a lot. I have already written two books. The one book is Science of Manifestation. Another book is Million Dollar Logo. And after that, I have been featured in a lot of things like magazines, newspapers. This is a newspaper, Hitwada, which is from the Vidarbha region. So it is very, very famous. I have been featured in that. You can see the handwriting of the mind. Magazine Smart Life, which gets published in Mumbai. So there also been featured. Then I have written articles on entrepreneur.com, and many more things are coming day in, day out. There is another newspaper, then another magazine, the Canbay Post. There also I have written, which is from Ahmedabad. So, these all things happens to me because of only one thing and only one thing. I choose to do something which I like. I choose to do something which I'm capable of, made up of, and my talents are suitable for this. Instead of going for the natural things like, engineering or doctor or, architects. Today, I am more successful in this field. I'm earning more than what I could have earned in the softwares. I did software job. Today, my income is in multiples of what I could have earned in the software. So this is the purpose of today's workshop, is to make you aware about the potential of graphology and to see graphology as a career option in future, because this is one of the best possible profession which you can prefer to do in future. So let me show you a small video to make you aware about how graphology works. Okay, it will load. How many of you like the video? How many of you understood the video? Now it's great that you all are keeping your videos on. Can you raise your hand? All of you who like the video, who understood it? Awesome. Great. Now let's understand. Yeah, very nice. Now let's understand the programming. What is the programming? Now I'm going to allow you all to speak if anyone wants to speak about this. So I'm going to ask this, why you do the things the way you do? Aap cheezon ko usi tarah se kyun karte ho jis tarah se aap karte ho? This is the question. How many, any one of you want to answer this? Okay. Kids, let me try. Yeah. Ravi Kishan, Ravi Shankar.
Ravi Shankar. And she's Anya. We are all our daddy's idea.
Okay, great. So why you do the things way you do?
Sir, because sir, we think that that is the right way for us.
So
it is easiest method for us.
For example, you walk in certain way, right? If I see you walking, I will come to know, okay, this person is walking. So why you walk in a particular way?
Sir, because we think this is the right way, or because we think that this is the easiest way to do it. Yes, sir.
Great, very nice. You know, I liked your confidence. Very nice. Yeah, anyone else wants to answer this? Why you do the things way you do? Why your father does the things the way they do? Do you think they do all the things right? No, right? Some things do. You also don't agree. Yeah, I will ask Arav to speak about this. Yeah. Yeah, Arav. Why you do the things way you do?
Sir, we do the things like we want to do because it makes the method easier to do it.
No, no, Arav, you are getting it wrong. Well, my question is, you do things without you being aware, right?
Yeah.
You being aware, for example, when you walk in certain way. When you talk in certain way. When you write in certain way, right? I will just see you and I will come to know, okay, Arav is walking, right? It is right like that. So why you walk in certain way?
We walk in certain way so that we can achieve that thing. And okay, we hope so that...
Let me ask you in another way. If you see your mom and dad walking from a distance, will you come to know that your mom and dad are walking?
So can you repeat?
If you see somebody is walking who... So can you get, will you know that your mom is walking or your dad is walking when you see your mom and dad from a distance? Will you see that? Will you come to know from their walking style?
If they will walk, so we will get to know they are walking.
Because you know their style of walking, right?
Yeah.
So they walk in a particular way, right? So why they do that thing without being aware? You do this thing without you being aware.
Because right? They are experienced of that style.
Very nice. This is a good word you use, experience. Now, my question to you all is, from where this experience comes?
Sir, should I answer this one also?
Yeah, why not? Go ahead.
No, because they practice, and when they practice,
they did not practice. You are not practicing walking, right? You are not practicing walking. You never practice walking and running. You might want to practice fast walking, fast running, slow running, but you cannot practice running. That is your natural style.
So right? when we do that work, so we get to know from this style we can achieve this.
Fine. Anyone else wants to last one? Anyone else wants to try? Okay, Rishabh is there. Yeah, somebody is saying very nice. Amit is saying, Amit Pandey, observation, yes. Okay, so she answered you for all, you know, observation. You know, you as a kid, you observe your parents, your society. You like something, you dislike something. And when you like, you copy. That is how you learn things. That is how you learn the way of walking. That is the way you learn the way of talking. Many of you get angry on some people, right? And this anger style is the copy of your mummy or daddy, right? Because you have seen them doing the same, and you now, when you are happy, you copy their style, because you get, this is called as the programming. You as a kid, you get programmed all the time by your mummy and by your daddy. Your mother and your father. Mother or mother-like people. Father and father-like people. You know, you might like your math teacher, you will start copying it. If you like your history teacher, you will start copying her. Are you guys getting it? Yeah? So, without you being aware, you get programmed. Without you being aware about this fact that what is good and what is bad, you just copy your mummy, daddy, because in your mind, you think that they are the correct. in your mind, you like them. There are only two ways in which you will get programmed. One is the love. If you love something, you will get programmed by that person or you will get programmed by that thing. And another is hate. When you are angry on something, when you don't like something, you will get programmed by that habit as well. So you will not believe, you will be a replica and a combination of your mummy and daddy, your dada and dadi, your nana and nani after some time. How many of you know, and how many of you have experienced this already, that you talk like your father, or you walk like your father, or you speak like your father? You do? How many of you do that? You know, Chaitanya says that he does. Right? So this is how you get programmed. So now this programming, we divide into two parts. The programming we divide into two parts. And what is those two parts? We say that, see, from 0 to 14 years of age, you get programmed. From 0 to 7, you get programmed by your mummy a lot. Yeah, like a robot. And from 7 to 14, you get programmed by your father a lot. So this is the time, 7 to 14 is the time where you should spend maximum time with your father, because this is the time your body increases with the rapid pace, your weight increases with the rapid pace, your confidence will also increase in the rapid pace if you get a support from your father over here, 7 to 14. 0 to 7, here you get programmed by a lady, a mother. And that is why you see all the kindergarten people having the lady as a teacher. There is no male teaching to you, no masculine person. There are all ladies teaching to you. Okay. So that is what this zero do. Here some part of male will be there, and here some part of female will also be there. Okay. So some male programming and some female also will get programmed. So this is about the programming. That is why we come to know about the way you think. Because now, whether you want or whether you don't want, you are a living robot. A robot with a choice. A robot who can upgrade and update his programs. But you are a robot. I am also a robot. You know, I also get angry like my father. I also get angry like my mother. I also love like my father. I also love like my mother. You know, I have learned the things from them. That is how animals learn from their own parents. You know. Great. Now, let's understand more about the programming and about the signature and handwriting. So, any questions? Yeah, Brainification has some question. Let me unmute. Okay. If you have a question, raise your hand. I will unmute and I will allow you to speak. So now, let's go back and learn more about the signatures. Are you guys enjoying? Are you guys enjoying or not? Yeah, great, awesome. So now, what is signature? Signature is your public image. The way other people are going to see you. Signature is your public image. And people will come to know about you, the way people are going to feel about you, see to you. All those things are being shown by your signature. When you sign, it means that you were present over there. So the way the entire public, entire people are going to see you can be seen in the signature. So signature is your public image, signature is your logo. So there are ways to do the signature. Let me tell you some ways. Before I go to this, let's start talking about some things about your page. How many of you go to school? Oh, wow. All of you. Very nice. Very nice. This is great. But in Corona time, I don't, how come you are allowed to go to school? ठीक है, ओके. यू नो यू दिस इज द लेफ्ट ऑनलाइन, या स्मार्ट आंसर. दिस इज राइट, दिस इज द पेज, दिस इज टॉप, दिस इज द बॉटम. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू आस्क यू वन क्वेश्चन अबाउट दिस. व्हाट इज द वन थिंग विच इज सेम फॉर एवरीबडी? योर मम्मी हैज इट, योर डैडी हैज इट, नरेंद्र मोदी हैज इट, शाहरुख खान हैज इट, विराट कोहली हैज इट, यू ऑल्सो हैव इट. वॉट इज द वन थिंग विच इज इक्वल फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू? इक्वल? नो, शाहरुख खान हैज अ डिफरेंट बॉडी, यू हैव डिफरेंट बॉडी. सो विच इज, यू नो, ब्रेन अगेन मे बी डिफरेंट. यू नो, अच्छा, एनिमल हैज इट, प्लांट हैज इट, योर अर्थ हैज इट. वॉट इज दैट वन थिंग विच इज देयर विथ एवरी वन? यस, no, no. What about the cycle has it, your car has it, everybody has it? What one thing which is equal for everyone, beggar or rich person? You guys are missing. Let me tell you, everyone has 24 hours in common. Nobody has get more and nobody has less, right? Tree, plant, rock, earth, everything has 24 hours as a time equal, right? Everyone got it? Sabke paas ek cheez jo equal hai, wo kaun si hai? Time. Everybody has got the same amount of time. And the blank page indicates 24 hours a day. Blank page indicates a day, and the way you are going to treat the blank page is the way you are going to treat a day. Now I'm going to ask you this thing, that what is the first thing which you have got from your mother? What is the first thing which you have got from your mother in your life? Love, okay. Life, okay. Love, personality, okay. Birth. And before birth, if I want to ask you, have you got anything before birth from your mother? Okay, Arav is getting pain from mother. No issues. We all do. Don't worry. So, So the first thing which you got from your mother is protection. Protection. She protected you, and now also she teaches you how to be safe. She tells you how to be safe all the time. So the first thing which you get from your mother is the protection, security. And that is what the left side of the page indicates, security. Because left is equal to mother. Left is equal to security. Left, your left brain is a feminine brain. Yeah? Sorry, your left brain is a feminine brain which controls the, sorry, right, your right brain is a feminine brain which controls your left side of your body. So this left side is for the mother, and your mother gives you the security for the first time. So the left side of the page indicates what? Left side of the page indicates past, parent, country, religion, and society. Because these all things gives you security. Past, parent, country. Your country protects you, right? Within the boundary. So your parent. And the right side of the page indicates the risk, opportunities, confidence, children, and success. This is on the right side. Do you know why your page has red lines when you try to write on the page? How many of you know it? What is the meaning of red lines in the page? Yeah, but wow, what is the meaning? Margins, that is okay, but why? Why you need to put those lines like that? Anyone who knows it? Because, you know, and those lines are in red color. Now, what is the red indicator? What is the meaning of red color? What is the meaning of red color? The meaning of red color is danger. Very nice. Amit is very, very charming. Who is Amit? Let me see. So right, red color means danger. What it means that you are not supposed to cross this boundary. Why? Because the left side is for past, parent, country, religion, and society. So these lines tells you that you need to protect, you need to care for your past, parent, country, religion, society. So that is why these boundaries are there. You know, because of this boundary, you cannot occupy this space. And when you donate the space, you are donating the time. And donation of time shows that you care and respect to those things. When you hear national anthem, what do you do? When you listen to a national anthem, what do? You stand, and then what? You stand in attention, and then what? Stand and you don't do anything. You know, you are just, either you sing or you keep mum. You are not supposed to do anything, right? When you go to somebody's cremation, you know, somebody is dead and you go there also you do what? You do nothing. You just go there and sit quietly. You don't speak much. After offering condolences, you are quiet over there. When some elderly person walks into your room, you know, you just stand and you don't do anything. You give them a space to sit. So that is what this means. When you offer a space to somebody, when you offer a time to somebody, it shows care and respect. So that is what your books teaches you, notebooks, that you should give empty space to your parents. You should give empty space to your nation, your religion, everything. And this is what it means. This is for care and this is for the respect. That is why when you respect somebody, if you are standing in front of them, you do this. Your head goes down, and when head goes down, automatically this space is empty, and this empty space shows that you want to give the respect to that person. So this is how the left and right things are there in your writing. So now let's understand a bit about the, let me handle the question, because now I see a lot of young kids, the kids who might not understand. I'm going to unmute you all. Make sure that you are on mute only when you are want to speak. Unmute yourself. Okay, go ahead. Anyone has any question up till now? Any questions?
Sir, I want to say something.
Yeah. Aura, please go.
I read in one book that that our left brain or our right brain is called the art brain, and this and the other brain is called our writing brain.
Your left brain is the brain whose art brain, very true, which is emotional, which is femininely influenced. And your left brain is a logical brain which controls the right side of your body, which is the calculative one. Very true.
But why is the brain divided into two parts?
Because the entire universe is divided into two parts. There are male, there is a female. There is a day, there is a night. So
good and bad. Good and bad.
Yeah, evil. Good and evil. Good and bad. Everything is there in the universe into two parts. There are two energies. So that is why your brain is also has two parts.
The positive and negative.
Yeah, positive and negative. That is how it operates.
White and black.
Yeah. Great. So, okay, you don't have any questions. Very nice. So, how many of you are ready to learn more about signature? How many are excited about learning about signatures? How many of you have signatures? How many of you have signatures? All of you are, wow, this is so great. Great. Very nice. Awesome. So let's understand about your signatures today. I'm going to mute you all again. Great. So since you all have signatures, let me make you aware how signature works. So first of all, I'm going to give you the small introduction about how they can work. So let's assume this is a page. And if this is a page, and on this page, let's assume you are writing. If I ask you to write some things for analysis and if you are writing some things. Okay. And if your signature is closer to the script, or your writing is signature is away from the script. So this is the script. This is script. Here you have written some things. And this is the signature. This is the signature. Position number one. Position number two. Don't write on the board, Arav. Don't do it. Okay. So if you sign whenever you, if you are writing, and if you write and if you sign closer to the script, it means that whatever you have written is in your heart. You and the script is connected. And if you are signing, if you are signing away from the script, it means that you and the script is not connected. Whatever you have written in the writing is not true. You don't identify yourself with that. Okay. Another thing. If the this is, let's assume this is the writing size. Your writing size is this. Writing size is equal to. Yeah. Your writing size is equal to A. Size. Okay. Writing size is equal to A. And the signature size is B. Signature size is equal to B. If these are the two parameters, writing size is equal to A and signature size is equal to B. So there will be three scenarios. Number one, writing size is equal to the handwriting signature size. Handwriting size is greater than the signature size. And number three is handwriting size is lesser than the signature size. Everybody is familiar with these four formulas. It is equal to greater than and less than, right? Yeah. So now, number one scenario, if you are, okay, Aru, you are sweet talker and you might be living in joint family as well. So that is what your signature tells me. Okay. So now the, if your signature size and your handwriting size is the same, if your handwriting size and signature size is same, it means that you in public and in private behave the same. You in public and in private life behave the same. If your handwriting size is greater than the size of signature, means if your signature size is smaller than the handwriting size, it means that you lose the confidence in public. You don't feel confident in public. You can't speak in public. Okay. You will not, you will be shy kid. You will not go out in the, in people. You will love to talk, you will like to talk people at one-to-one level. If your signature size is greater than the size of handwriting, number three scenario. Okay. Number three scenario, if your handwriting size is smaller than the size of signature, if your signature is bigger than the size of your handwriting, it means that you feel confident in public. You will go out in the public and you will talk. You will be good at stage. You will be, you feel confident whenever there are people around you. So it means that everyone understood? Yeah, everyone understood, right? This is the scenario of the signature. Okay, now again, because you guys are so small, no? Okay, great. Everyone understood. So I would like to handle your questions because I don't know how much you guys are understanding. Yeah. Any questions from your side? Everybody understood?
Sir.
Yes. Yes, Aura.
I didn't understand the first
point. Is this voluntary or involuntary action?
Okay, great. So,
sir, if the first point that you said about that, if your handwriting is similar as that, so then I didn't understand what does that mean about you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much for asking. Let me again make you aware about that. Okay. So it means, what it means that you don't behave differently in public and in private scenarios. You might have seen people that when people are on stage, they behave differently. They act way differently. But there, you might have seen some kind of hero performing on the stage who feels very confident on the stage. But when you meet to that same person at private level, they are different. Your teachers, for that matter. When they are teaching you, they are different. When you go to talk to them at one-on-one level, they are different to you, right? They talk to you very sweetly. But when you talk, they are handling the whole class, they talk very differently to you. So this is a different kind of behavior, public behavior and a private behavior. When your signature is equal to, the signature size equal to the size of handwriting, then your behavior is same in public as well as in private. But if the size are changing, then your behavior changes. Your confident level goes up and down with the signatures. The size in the handwriting shows the confidence. The more the size, more the person is confident. Smaller the size, the person becomes, if the signature size is smaller, then the person loses the confidence in public. The bigger the size, the person feels more confident in public. Then, of course, there are a lot of rules to that as well, but this is the basic what we are talking and teaching to you. Okay. Any more questions? You can type in if you have any questions. I will explain you. So we understood about the left and right part. Do you know there are some language which travels from right to left? There are some languages which travel in this way. In this way that they travel. Do you know? Wow. Dhanisha knows Urdu. Okay. What about others? Arabic. Kritika says Arabic. Very true. What else? Japanese, I know, don't know. But Arabic, yes. Urdu, yes. Sindhi, yes. So these people are traveling from here to here. And this is about what? This is about past, parent, country, religion, and society. So when a language travels from right to left, it means these people will talk about, these people will talk about the religion. That is why Pakistan, which has the Urdu as their national language, will talk about religion. They will talk about nation. They will talk about religion, country, past. Okay. And writing is the word you write is voluntary action, but the word, the way it comes onto the paper is an involuntary action. Somebody was asking that. So this is the answer to that. So now, what does it mean when handwriting is bigger than signature? When handwriting is bigger than signature, it means that this person doesn't feel confident in public. This person loses his confidence in public. This person doesn't want to face public. See, when you are happy, your body expands. And when you are sad, your body shrinks. Understood? So all of you do this. You know, any one moment of your life which you feel, any one incident of your life about which you feel sad, not very very sad, but okay sad, you know, you might be having English and Hindi. Okay, you want me to speak in English and Hindi? Okay, so any incident in your life about which you are not feeling happy, a small incident, it doesn't have to be great. Just remember, just close your eyes and remember that incident of your life about which you feel sad. Koi bhi ek incident jahan pe aapko thoda sa bura laga. To imagine karo, sab log bura laga, lag raha hai bura, hai na, feel kar rahe ho, bura laga, kaise lag raha hai, bura lag raha hai sabhi ko, 1 se 5 ke beech mein, na. Abhi kya karo, sabhi log khade ho jao, aur apne haath jo hai, aise, aise baju mein karo, haath, aur upar ki taraf dekho. Look up. And now try to think about this bad incident and now try to feel the bad again. ऐसे ऊपर की तरफ देखो एंड ट्राई टू फील बैड, बैड, रियली रियली बैड. जो बैड फीलिंग आपके मन में आया था और जो वो फीलिंग वापस से आ पाया, तो कम बैक टू द नॉर्मल पोजिशन. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू वर एबल टू डू इट? हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू वर एबल टू? नो, यू कैन नॉट फील बैड इन दिस पोजिशन. यू ट्राई अगेन इफ यू फेल्ट बैड, यू नो, यू ट्राई टू फील बैड, यू नो, यू कैन नॉट फील बैड. Because this is a position of abundance. Here you are expanding your body and you are aligning your body to receive the universal energy. So the moment you are happy, confident, you expand. That is why when you are happy, you do this. Yay, right? Because this is the expansion. When you are sad, you see this, you do like this, grumpy. So when your signature size is big, you feel confident, you feel strong. If your signature size is small, you lose the confidence, you feel small. So any elderly people, you know, other than kids, wants to speak and ask questions? Yeah. Kritika, you want to ask some good question? Yeah, anyone? Great. Okay. If you just raise the hand in the app, if it is possible to you, so that I will unmute you and I will allow you to speak. Okay. So many questions. Let me stop this and let's handle the questions. Okay. I hope. Yeah. I'm allowing you to unmute, Kritika.
Yeah. Good afternoon, sir. Sir, actually, I have a question that sometimes some people, they only use their name, the first name as the signature. And sometimes we add only the initial letter and then followed with the surname. So okay. How does that impact us? Very, I mean, nice. What's the difference between that?
Great. Thank you for asking this question. Let me explain you this question. What is your signature? When you talk about name, when you talk about surname, what about when you talk about your father's name, when you talk about your mother's name? You know, when you talk about your own name, it's about you as an individual. You as an individual means you as a boy or you as a girl. Okay. When, for example, let me share you my own signature. Let's assume that this is my signature. Sudhir Lakshman Khove is my, let's assume this is my name. Let's assume this is my signature. So the first thing of this signature is what? The first thing of signature is my own initial. So this thing, whatever is representing me, this thing first is for me. The way I am going to behave as a boy. The way I am going to behave as a boy. The second initial or second part, which is my father's initial or the father's name, this will tell me the way I am going to behave as a father. The way I'm going to behave as a boss, the way I perceive my father, मैंने मेरे father को कैसे देखा, कैसे समझा, कैसे जाना. So the way I'm going to perceive my father, this will be told by the number two position. Number three, this is the initial of my signature. It tells me the person, the third initial will tell me the way I'm going to behave as a mother, the way I'm going to treat kids, take care of them, motherly behavior, emotional behavior. All those things will be shown by the letter K, which is the first initial of my signature. So the way I am going to behave as my mother, the way my mother behaved with me, the way my kids are going to behave with me, the way my wife is going to behave with me. Why? Because they are going to carry my surname forward. So these people are going, this K is going to show me the way I behave as an emotional person. And the rest of the part of the signature is going to show me the way I occupy my remaining time, my remaining life. So when somebody is only writing their name, if somebody is writing only their name, what happens in this case? If this person, let's assume this person is writing his only name. So this person is missing two parts. One is father and one is mother. So this person now misses the emotional aspect. Mother is not there, so emotional aspect not there. So this person becomes a bit of non-emotional person. This person will not be sacrificing. See, no, now the Sudhir is this much, S is this much. So if I am writing the Sudhir full, then I am occupying my all the pay, you know, pace, whatever required. Jitna lag raha utna sab occupy kar raha. I'm not giving the space to other people. But when I do only yes, it's like sacrifice. I am ready to sacrifice my space. So Sudhir will not, if this is the way you do the signature, you will do the things in your own way. You will not sacrifice your way of doing things for someone else. You will be selfish in nature. You will be very good as an administrator. Why? Because you don't care about others' emotions. So you can take non-emotional decisions, and all administrative people are supposed to take non-emotional decisions. So writing only name in signature will force you to become non-emotional person, but you will do things in your own style. That is why all heroes, all actors have the signature in which they write their own name. Shah Rukh writes Shah Rukh. So when you write Shah Rukh, it's like you have your own style of doing things. You like to do things in your own way. That is the stylish things. Understood? So writing only name and signature will promote you as individual person, and you will have your own style of doing things. Yeah. Any other question? Okay. Not mentioning surname does mean that the person wants to create his own identity. Okay, so not mentioning surname, it means that the person has not seen the importance of his mother in his life. Somewhere mother was busy and he has not seen mother in the house, in his life. Because he had not seen that, now he doesn't want to include mother in or emotional things or emotional figure in his life. Now he will not write the surname in the signature. It means that, yeah, it also means that he will want to create his own identity. Yes, because he is not including his emotional part, his roots. Okay. So this is about, if somebody is writing only surname as a signature, what happens with that person? Now that person is trying to give lot of importance to what? The emotions. So here there is one principle. The principle is called as principle of exaggeration. When something is overridden in the handwriting, opposite is the truth. So if somebody is trying to write only surname as a signature, this person shows that his person is too much emotional, but opposite is the truth. He is not emotional at all. And you know, he is trying to hide behind it. Okay, how many of you have this kind of ascending signatures? No, if I talk about the angles, how many of you do this kind of signature, ascending? How many of you this kind of signature, ascending signature? How much ascending? This much, this much, this much. Position number one, position number two, position number three. How many are there for position number one? Just write position number one, 45 degree. How many of you have this kind of signature, you know, ascending? Bhavya has position number two, position number one. Aaron, Rishabh. Okay, position number four, horizontal. Excuse me. Okay, so the people who all are in the agent calculus is, you are not understanding. This is about the angle in the signature. It's not about the slant. Okay, it's not about the slant. It's about the angle. So when you have first kind of signature, where you have signature which is 45 degrees. If the signature is 45 degree, what happens to these kind of people? These people try to achieve a lot. They expect a lot from themselves. If the signature is 45 degree, these people expect a lot from themselves. They want to do a lot of work. They put a lot of efforts and they are dissatisfied from themselves. They always feel that they are capable of more. So all the people who said position number one. Am I right or wrong? Gunjan, Arhat, Amit. Right? When you do this kind of signature, there is a chance that you might get pain in your upper back and in your neck. If you are doing the signature of this sort, you will get pain in your upper back or in your neck. Okay. If you are doing this kind of signature, position number 3, 30 degree approximately, add this stage here. What happens here? Here, you also expect too much from yourself and your pain will be around your chest area, on the backside, of course. But you will also expect too much from yourself. When it's 25 degree, these people are never down in their attitude. They will be always positive. They will always want to try and achieve more things. You know, they will always speaking about positive things. They will have this mindset of having the mindset of what? Mindset of enthusiasm all the time. Okay. And when somebody has a straightforward signature, this person is normal. This person is not enthusiastic. This person is the way the things are. No, he is not. He will never be too much excited for anything. All other signature, 25 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, these people are always excited in their mindset. Okay. Great. Yeah, again, we are back to the question answer session. Let's handle more questions. Yeah. So, what about no margins? When you don't leave any kind of margins, it means that you are not caring for people's emotion. You become workaholic and you become non-emotional, non-caring as well. Aro wants to speak. Do you have a question? Aro? Yeah, okay. Go ahead.
So can you tell me what this signature means?
Aro, this is not easy to, you know, just see in that picture.
Yes.
Right now. But this is not the way we are going to take this class because everybody will want their signature to be analyzed. What we will do, we will take this at personal level. Right now, you ask question, I will answer the question instead of analyzing your own signature. Okay. Do you have any question other than this?
No, sir.
Okay. Why drawing books have no margins? Because there are no rules. That is for creativity. Drawing books are for creativity. And creativity is not supposed to be in the any kind of rules. It has to be, there shouldn't be any rule for creativity. Anything can be creativity, right? Anything can be creative. That's why there are no lines in the drawing books. Okay. Signature with your father's name only. This person tries to show that when you only write your father's name in the signature, you want to show the world that you are action-oriented person. You want to show that you are full of action, but opposite will be the truth. Okay. Okay. Which is the most appropriate sign? Most appropriate sign is the sign which suits to your goals, your objectives, your emotions, your mindset. What you want to achieve in your life. The signature which is aligned with that purpose is the most suitable signature for you. If your signature is curved, but our handwriting is straight, then what is the impact? See, I can't understand your question. What do you mean by curve? What do you mean by straight? You know, there is nothing called as curved signature or straight signature or curved handwriting and straight handwriting. Can a handwriting show sign of clinical depression or mania? Yes, it does. Yeah, it will. It can. It is there all the time. Let's ask Vandana Mishra a question. Yeah, Vandana, please go ahead.
Sir, no, I normally sign like.
Can you repeat? I'm not able to hear you.
Like my name is Vandana. So V, I will write, and from the V loop only S will overlap, and then I will write Mishra. And this I used to do when my maiden surname was V R Shukla. Always my father's initial or my husband's initial overlapped V. So that means I am dependent, or I am. What is the reason why I do? I am not independent. Like,
yeah. Whenever you have like my name. Overlapping signature, in the sense you, when you overlap initials in the signature, your name, your father's name, your surname, whenever you overlap you, the, in the signature, it means you lack clarity. It means the mind is not very clear. It also means you are dependent, and you, people are dependent on you. It's not only one way traffic, it is two way traffic. A person whose initial you are trying to overlap will be dependent on you. So you will be dependent on somebody, and that person will also be dependent on you. So yeah, you will not be independent. That is very true. And confused, yes, you will be confused as well at the same time.
Yeah. So it's better to change that signature?
See, it depends on what kind of work you are doing, what kind of success you want, what do you want to achieve. It depends on that. At times, not changing signature is also good. At times, changing signature is good. It depends on what you exactly want to achieve and what will give you more satisfaction, more success, more money, more recognition, more happiness. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, Aru saying, you said that when your handwriting is smaller than your signature, then you are not convinced. Yes. No. When your signature is smaller than your handwriting size. Remember, size is confidence. The more the size, the bigger is the confidence. So smaller the size, smaller will be the confidence. So handwriting size, if it is smaller than the signature, it's good. You are confident in public. Yeah, Gunjan, go ahead for the question. Yeah, Gunjan. Okay, I will handle another question from, you said that when handwriting is smaller than your signature. No, Yaya already answered that. Then we Kiyur Parikh, please go ahead. Just raise your hand so that I come to know about who wants to ask question. Kiyur Parikh. Does a line below a signature indicate anything? Yes, it does. It shows how many of you do a underscore below the signature. How many of you do the underscore below the signature? Awesome. This is called an underscore. Whenever you do underscore below the signature, if this is the way you do the signature, you have underscore below the signature, it means that you guys feel confident. And unless and until you are confident about something, you don't want to say things about that to others. You know, this is about conviction. You need to be convinced about the things before you start speaking with the other people. Agent Calculus, you, this is, there are a lot of kids, no? We should not talk about some things over here. Be, you know, you, what you are asking and what you are discussing and what is the purpose of this class is something different, right? So just be aware. I know that you know something a bit about, you must have read something. I can see it from your questions, but this is not the platform where we speak about all these things. Yeah. So the underscore below the signature shows conviction. Yeah, Kyoji, please go ahead. Ask question.
Yeah, hi. Just wanted to know, what if someone does a curve below the handwriting, I mean, below the signature?
Okay.
Or probably, you know, there are zigzag way, straight line, there are various ways. So what does it indicate that?
Okay. So, yeah, great. There are multiple ways in which you can do a signature like this. You know, some people may do like this, you know. Then somebody will do a signature like this. So, and then what? Then, you know, if you do this kind of signature where the there is a curve of this sort, it shows that you want to improve a lot. You are constantly on self-improvement drive. You will improve bit, pace, everything slowly, slowly in your life. So this is the self-improvement curve. If somebody does this kind of signature, it means this person has a tendency to do excuses for not performing. So this person will speak with a lot of ifs and buts. You know, it's like he will give a lot of reasoning. The reason behind this. He will always keep on giving you the reason, a reference and reason. If somebody has this kind of signature, zigzag, this kind of line, it means that this person is good with the coordination. This person is very good with the coordination. If you have this kind of signature.
Okay. So, can a change of signature changes personality in a phase of time?
Yes, it does. It changes you completely. If you change your signature, you will be a different person after some days. Maybe 2 months, maybe 3 months, depending on your practice. Okay. But you will be a different person. That is what I have achieved in my life.
And same implies with the handwriting also. In like someone who's not that confident with the change of handwriting with some specific alphabets or words, can he be more confident?
Yes. More confident, more successful, more intelligent. You know, Mars doesn't show intelligence at all. Mars and intelligence has no connection. So we, from handwriting, we come to know, okay, this person is genuinely intelligent. You might have seen some intelligent kids who do not get good marks in the exam. But those kids are not dumb. They understand, but they can't remember. Now, memory is something else and intelligence is something else. So the people who have good memory will get good marks in the exam. But the genuinely intelligent person will understand what he is learning.
Right.
So that you can come from, get to know from the handwriting.
Fantastic. Yeah. Thank you. Very informative. Thanks, Adan.
Kritika, your question.
Sir, actually, I want to know that some of few people I have seen, even I have a habit of, you know, putting dots, full stop after the signature. Earlier, I used to put one, but now I don't know. Automatically, now I have started putting two dots. I don't understand what, but that is different.
Like this?
I want to.
Like this or like this?
No. I'm about it. I have started putting two dots, but earlier there was one dot. But always it was my habit that I am putting dots after my signature.
What is the position?
It's the fourth one, sir. The fourth one.
Two dots at the fourth place. Yeah. Two or one? How many dots? Two dot or one dot, Kritika? Two dots. Okay, fine. So, see, if you are, see, let's understand first of all the position number one. So, we understood about the dot. What is dot? Dot is nothing but a thought. One dot is equal to one thought. One dot is equal to one thought. And you are also one thought. You are also one thought. Somebody thought that let's have a baby and you got born. So you are also one thought. So when you one dot, it means you. But when you do you two dot, it means you are including someone else also. So two dots mean there are two people. So two dots mean you want to be with someone all the time. Two dots mean you want to be with someone. Understood? Now you tell me if somebody is giving the two dots at the position number two, what does it mean? One, what does it mean? What will be the position number one mean? What will be the meaning of this? So, yeah, yes. So the position number one, what is position number one? See, we discuss about left and right, right? So left is about your family. Left is about your country, security, all those things. So let me mute. So what does left indicate? This particular dot giving on the left indicates that you want to be with the people from your family. You are comfortable to be with them and you want to be with them only. So this is about the two dots on the left hand side. If you give two dots, how many of you give two dots at the middle of your signature? How many of you give the two dots at the middle of your signature? Nawal Khan, okay. So the two dots, when you give two dots at the center, this is a position which is not very known and what not very unknown. So here you have friends who are like cousins and cousins who are like friends. So you, there are friends in your family or there are friends who come to your house and eat and you go to somebody's house and eat. So you develop that kind of friendship when you have two dots at the center of your signature. So friends like cousins and cousins like friends. This is what the position number two dot indicates. When you give the dots at the end, third position, position number, yeah, perfect. Thank you, Nawal. So when you give the dots at the end of the signature, what happens here that you become friendly with strangers. You can talk to unknown people. You feel confident with unknown people. You make friends with strangers. You make friendship with strangers. So how many of you do the position number three dots? So these people are very good for marketing. If you go, you know, if you go for, if you want to do a marketing, then position number three dots are the people who are extremely friendly with strangers. Now when at position number four, if you give only one dot at the position number four and that too all the time in front of line immaculately, perfectly, it means that you are particular about things. But if you start giving two dots instead of one over here, it means that you are wasting your time at non-required places. Places where you're not supposed to spend time, you tend to spend time at that place. This is what it means. So this was about the dotting. So let me... allow, you know, Mrs. Norina Fernandez is already here and let us hear something from her as well. You know, she has been the strength and backbone for this particular session. She is the one who has introduced me to you all. So let us hear something from Mrs. Norina Fernandez.
Okay, so good afternoon, everybody, and good afternoon, Sudhir. Welcome to this platform where most of my students are there, and they're so little.
Yeah, very small.
Right from standard 2 to standard 6. And I think what I want to sort of reinforce with this session is that they are in the formative ages of developing their handwritings, their skills for writing, and also maybe construct their signatures. So some of the tips that you give, maybe they can reinforce it and they can learn more about it, right? Yeah. And if they have some very genuine questions, because you know how children particularly are, and at PIS Mira Road, they like to ask a lot of questions. But we love when they ask questions, okay? So take that patiently. And thank you once again for whatever you have to tell them. And thank all the students for the afternoon that they've just finished their class. They will be getting into the exams typically. The revision exams. Okay, so not exams. Like you said, I believe one thing very, very strongly. And that is, you know, marks come as a byproduct. They are never important for me, never. So we have every day a skill learning session that happens. And the ones who are, more skilled, they are more capable of a lot of things. And the right example is you right in front of them. So thank you so much, Sudhir, for making the afternoon a very interesting place to learn. And thank you for coming to our school with our students. And I remain very, very grateful to you for that. Thank you.
And thank you very much. So let's take the questions from the kids because the direction has to be
right.
Yes.
I want to ask a question.
Yes, go ahead. Please go ahead.
So my question is, what if the dots are above the signature?
Okay. So above the signature, there are multiple ways of, instead of that, why don't we focus on something with which you guys, you know, small kids can learn and improve their own life. Of course, elders can do the same, but you know, ask questions about your, you know, what do you want to achieve, what do you want to improve, what do you want to do in your life.
Sir, how we can improve a bad handwriting?
Okay, so what is a bad handwriting?
So which is not a good handwriting. Which is scribbling.
Huh?
Which looks like scribbling.
Which looks like scribbling. If somebody's handwriting you cannot read, if it's not readable, it's called as illegible handwriting. The handwriting which is not legible. So it means when your handwriting is not good, it means that this person is very moody, this person is not consistent, and this person is what you can say is like this person doesn't have patience. Okay, so if you see this kind of handwriting where the handwriting is always going like this, you know he's writing like this. So this is the way, it is called as threading in our language. So if you do this kind of handwriting, then this person doesn't have patience. So his success rate will be very, very low. So whatever you do in your life, always make sure that you write very clearly. It should be readable. Even if your writing is not good, it should be readable. If you can read it, it means that this person is patient enough to do the things, and this person will surely achieve success.
Sir, I have one question.
Yeah.
Sir, whenever I write slow, it becomes neat. Whenever I write fast, it does not become neat. So how to improve it?
Write slow. Practice more. So that your handwriting will come better. But if you write fast and it is not coming good, it means that you are trying to take shortcuts. You are trying to take shortcuts when you don't have time, right? So when the situation is not comfortable for you, Sandeep, you lie as well. It means that when there is a lot of pressure on you, you crumble under that pressure. Are you getting it, Sandeep, what I'm trying to say?
I'm actually Vian.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Most of the time in the notebook, I do scribbling.
Okay.
What's the meaning of that?
You do doodles, you mean to say. Here and there, you tend to write, you draw flowers, you do the newspaper, you know. No? Scribbling means what? So how many of you do doodles? How many of you do doodles? You know, you on the book, here, there. How many? You know, just raise your hand. Awesome. So many of them. You know, all of you, your mummy cooks. Yeah. Your mummy cooks very tasty food, good food. Am I right or wrong? Yes? Very nice. Then your mummy.
What do you think?
Yeah, your mummy is very particular about cleanliness in your house. Am I right or wrong? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, very particular. And she is also very particular about the kind of bed sheets she wants to have. Very smooth, very soft. Right?
Yes, sir. Sir, correct.
Yes, sir.
Now,
yeah.
How I came to know about this, you know, is because you doodle.
Sir, I have a question.
Wait a minute. Because you have doodle habit. The moment why you doodle? You doodle because you are not allowed to do something which you want to do at home. So, you are not allowed to change things at your home. So you change those things on your book, on newspaper, on somewhere else. Are you getting it?
Sir, I have a question. Can I say?
Yes.
Handwriting, when we write fast.
No, I did not get your question. What is your question?
Sir, if we have we have to do our handwriting also good, so how to do that?
Okay, so see, when you say good handwriting, I believe that you want to be more successful in life. You want to achieve more name, fame, recognition, you know, peace, family, everything. So the one trait which I want all of you to practice in your handwriting, and one trait with which I want you to prosper in your life is this. Now, what is this? Can you tell me what is this?
No, it's line.
Which line is it? What kind of line?
Sir, blue color?
This is called as horizontal line.
Horizontal.
Okay, so there are letters in your handwriting which are in the which have the horizontal line. For example, T. Right? So I want all of you to focus on crossing these three properly. If you cross these three properly, that is at the top. That is at the top. You know, you don't cross T at lower level. If you cross T at lower level, what it means that your aims and objectives are low. If you cross the T at higher level, okay, it means that your aims and objectives are high. And while crossing, make sure that your T crossbar is horizontal and it is strong, the width is more, the pressure is good, and it is cutting to the T. If you do this, then whatever the kind of handwriting you have, you still will be very, very successful in life. Sir, in whatever you do. Are you getting it?
Sir, I have a question.
Wait a minute, Ravi. So what I'm trying to say to all of you is that if you practice this horizontal line, whenever this horizontal line is coming, it may come in the A, it may come in the H, it may come in the T. Whenever you are doing the horizontal lines, make sure that you are putting pressure, make sure you are doing a proper kind of crossing to the T, to the A, to the H. This tendency of doing good horizontal crossbar will make sure that you are achieving a lot of good things in your life and you are not running away from the challenges which you will be facing in your life. Okay? Yeah. Yeah. Now you can ask questions.
Whenever teacher gives us homework to write and I have to complete it fast, I just finish it in the class. Still also, I forget to put the line, the T. And when my ma'am checks, she tells that, is this L or is this T?
Correct. So, see, the vertical line in T is for the planning. And the horizontal line in the T is for the implementation. So, do you want to be the person who will achieve a lot of things in your life? Yes, right? So don't ever forget to write a T crossbar because it means that you are casual with your efforts. If you forget to cross the T, it means that you are not putting efforts to do the things in your life. You are casual. It means that your parents are not putting enough pressure on you to perform things. Okay. So always make sure that you have T crossbar. This is called a T crossbar. So always be sure that you are putting the crossbar at the T. This will give you a lot of fighting attitude. See, talented people never win the race. Who win the race? The one who practices every single day. So this T crossbar makes sure that you will practice every single day. If you are very, very talented, it's a good thing. But you know what? Success comes to those people who are consistent. So this T crossbar will make sure that you are consistent in your life all the time. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Great.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I was having a question. If you are putting the dot over I, a single small dot, but if you are putting it like a bigger dot or in a circular V, so what does it mean?
So do you have a circular dot in your eye? How many of you have tendency of putting circular dot in the eye? Okay.
Sir, sometimes I put a heart on my eye.
Okay. So all the people who put circular dot on eye are the people who like to eat chocolates, ice cream and cakes. Yes, all the people who put I dot in circular way are the people who like to play with kids. They are childish in nature and they are attention seeker. They like to seek attention of other people.
Yes, sir.
Sir?
Yes?
Yeah. I always put sometimes on I dot or else some designs.
When you put heart on the I, this was Arua, Aura. So when you put heart, it means that you like to say sorry and thank you.
Sir?
Yeah, Amit?
Shaurya.
Yeah, Shaurya.
Sir, my question was, what if our line is not always on the line?
Always on the line. Okay, while writing.
Yeah. So that, yes, sir.
Okay. So there are multiple ways. No, we cannot discuss right now because it has to be taught in a different way. But you know, there are four or five types of lines. When you write, you can write on the line, you can write just above the line, you can write in between the lines, you can write
so on the top of line. I have a question.
Yeah.
That after a signature, I put one dot, and then I put under that signature then line. One line only. What that mean?
I will have to see the signature for it. I mean, yeah. So
right okay, now, sir,
yeah. No, not tonight. Right now. I will see it afterwards.
Sir, I have a question. That what if I forgot what was my question.
So any see instead of
signature copy dekh ke nahi bolne wale bola abhi itne short time mein sab sabka signature nahi dekhte rehte hain.
Okay, I'm going to mute you all again.
Apne handwriting se related
to. Yeah, ask something with which you can improve your life if you are struggle, you know. Great. Yeah, Aro, go ahead.
So how can I score good marks?
Okay, so Aro, how much important is it for you to score good marks?
So can you repeat?
How much important is it for you to score good marks? Achhe marks lena aapke liye kitna important?
So it is important for me because it makes me feel happy.
And why is that? What will happen if you get good marks?
So if I get good marks, I feel happy and I feel that I can achieve more.
So let me ask you this question. What about your mommy and daddy? Do they have good marks?
So what?
Your mommy and daddy, do they have good marks in their exam?
Yes, sir.
They have? What yes, if they have only good marks and they are not good as a parent? If they beat you, if they don't treat you well, if they don't feed you well, what will be more valuable for you? Having good marks in their mark sheet or they being good mommy, daddy for you?
Good mommy and daddy.
Correct. So similarly in life also, what you need to focus on right now is how I can be a good as a human being. How can I contribute more to the society? How can I be good to other people? How can I be more loving? You know, these are the qualities you should be focusing more on. How can I be good with my servants? How can I be good with the kids, with the trees, with the animals, with the earth? These are the qualities on which you should have more focus on, because these are the qualities which will help you to become more successful in life. Good marks will help you to get good job. But believe me, in that job also, you will be bored. You will also be, it's like, no, you will be frustrated because you will not be good human being at that time. So right now, your focus should be on how I can be good human being instead of getting good marks. Because you never ask, when you got birth, you never ask your mommy and daddy, okay, what is your marks? How many marks you got in the 10th? Okay, if you do not got 90 marks, I will not stay with you. You are staying with your mommy and daddy still without knowing their mark sheet, right? You are not seeing their mark sheet, right, Aro?
Yes, sir.
And did you check before getting the birth? So,
no, sir.
Your focus has to be on how I can be a very good human being. How can I be loving with others, with myself? That is what your focus should be today. Okay? Any elder who wants to ask question? Maybe Kritika or who else? Yeah, Arua, go ahead. Aura, please go ahead. Unmute and yes.
Sir, that if somebody writes half of the time on the eye a heart and half of the time a circle, that what does that mean?
Okay, we already have discussed this question already. We told that people are immature, childish, attention seeker, likes to eat chocolate ice cream and cakes, and heart also means the same. The only different thing is they like to say sorry and thank you, right, Arua? Aura, you like to say sorry and thank you a lot, right?
Yes.
Great. Yeah, Amit, go ahead.
Sir, my question was how to be impressive.
How to be impressive?
Impressive.
Okay, what do you mean by that? Yes, impressive, sir. Impressive mean what?
Sir, to create impression on others.
Yeah, it means you want other people to notice you. It means you want other people to remember you.
Yes,
it means you want other people to give value to you. Okay, how can you achieve that in your life? For you to be impressive to the others, the only thing which is valued most in the world right now is your ability, your value. So your ability to create impact is directly proportional to your ability to create the value in others' life. If you as a person are able to create value in somebody's life, people will automatically recognize you, people will automatically value you. Like some, for example, if you see Pradhan Mantri Modi walking towards you, you will feel overjoyed, you will see and you will feel happy because you know he has immense ability to put value to your life, put contribution to your life. So if you want to be impressive to the others, if you want other people to notice you, if you want other people to acknowledge you, make sure that you increase your own value. And how can you do that? To increase your own value, the easiest method to increase your own value is by acquiring more knowledge, by being more knowledgeable. Read more books, read more stuff, understand, study, and be valuable to other people. So that whenever you speak to somebody, that person should feel like, wow, by talking to this person, I am getting enlightened. I am getting to know a lot of things. I am getting much better in life. So they will be behind you. They will be always wanting to talk to you. So this helps. This is the way you can be very, very impressive. Only one way, becoming more valuable. Learn more, put efforts, and become more better in life. Understood, Amit? Yeah?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. So, Rishabh Kadam wants to speak. Yeah.
Sir, which pen or pencil is good for better
Thank you very much. Yeah, thank you very much for asking this question. This is a very good question for all the kids. As a kids, you should be allowed to write more with the pencils. Why? Because when you write with the pencils, you can rub whenever you do mistakes. What it means that we are accepting you as a person who can do mistakes. So writing with the pen will not allow you to rub your mistakes, but writing with the pencil will help you to change the way you think, change the way you, if you do some kind of mistake, you will be rubbing it off. So use as much as pencil as possible, but not in the exams. Exams, use pen, because pen will make that writing with the pen means commitment. And try to use ball pens instead of gel or ink pens. Gel and ink pen takes away the pressure from your handwriting. Gel pen or ink pen takes pressure away from your handwriting. And at your age, the pressure means the commitment. When you write with the pressure on the page, it means you are committed to the task. So the more pressure you give, the more you will be committed and more success will follow in your way. So write with the ball pen instead of ink and gel pen or pencil in the exams, you know, go for the ball pens. Yeah.
Sir, I have a question that while writing, I write two types. That is, one is cursive writing.
Yeah, it is too specific.
And second is normal.
I will stop you over. Ask something which is going to be beneficial for all the people. Okay, this is too specific. I will take it afterwards. Anyone else? Vandana? Vandana Mishra?
So, my son, he forgets to write the capital. Like when you have to start the sentence, then it has to start with capital. So, is it a mistake of remembering the grammar or the way of writing, or is it something else?
What is the age of the kid?
He's 10-year-old, 6th standard student.
It means that when somebody is not writing capitals properly, this is a very good question. This is for all of you, all the kids. Make sure that whenever you are writing, you need to give proper capitalization. It means whenever you are starting the sentence, or it means if you are writing somebody's name, or if you are, you know, tagging India, writing India and all, or God. So always put proper capitals. What is the meaning of capitals? Capitals meaning is giving proper importance. Capitals meaning is taking initiative. So if you are not writing capitals properly, it means that your priorities are wrong. You are not able to prioritize your work. So if a kid of a 10-12 year old is not writing capitals properly, it means that this kid is not able to prioritize his work. So make sure that whenever you're writing, all the kids, make sure whenever you're writing, remember about what is capital and where you need to capital, because this will help you to organize your life in proper way. You will be giving importance to right things because of this. Yeah, Nawal Khan, can you just unmute and speak?
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wanted to ask about the font. Is it better to encourage kids to write neat, clean and separate words, or they need to have these cursive writings? Like my son, he tends to write a lot of stylish ways, you know, curvy T stands and curvy A and all that kind of stuff. So does it need to be stopped, or no, it can be, you know, continued?
Yeah, so the problem with the lot of stylish writing is the person will face a lot of challenges in his life, because a lot of styles are not good for the mind. There are strokes called as ending stroke, starting strokes, you know, unnecessary hooks, unnecessary loops. Those complicate your way of thinking. And because in stylish writing, you only will see those kind of loops, hooks, or, you know, strokes. So that will, for watching, it looks very impressive. But the writer will undergo a lot of challenges in their life because of that kind of writing. So it's not advisable for you to have the very stylish writing. Yeah. Of course, you need to show it to us as well to make sure, okay, this writing is correct. Yeah, Khush. Khush Chauhan.
Yes, sir. I have a question that if our handwriting goes in a slanting line way, so what does it mean?
Slant, okay, the slants has a multiple impact. Slants talks about the expression. So we cannot discuss, because this is too much of detailing. Right now we cannot discuss this, but slant will show you the way you are going to express your feeling. So if you want to know about more about slants, I have my own YouTube channel where I keep on sharing the things. My YouTube channel, you can search with the name Sudhir Kove. And on that YouTube channel, you will be getting to know about what is the slant's meaning and what is your slant and all. Okay, so search with this particular thing, name on the, yeah. Okay, Ravi Shankar. Let me unmute Ravi Shankar. He has asked a question. Yeah. So, yeah, Vandana, go ahead, your question.
So, these handwriting rules are different for different languages, or it applies to same language? Because I might be using a different kind of underlying or overwriting or different way of writing the alphabets. So is the rule same for all the languages, or there are different rules for Hindi and English?
The rules are same for all the languages. That is why when you talk about South Indian language, they are more curvier in nature. That's why South Indian people are more emotional, more illogical. That is why their movies, when you see, they are more illogical movies, no? A person just flies without visa and goes to the US and all, no? So those kind of things happen in their movies because the writing is more of a curvier in nature. A lot of curves. Curve means emotions. Curve means illogicalness. Okay? So it applies to every language. Yeah. Yeah. So anyone who is asking question related to... I teach this particular science. I have my own website. On that, the science is already there, listed. You can learn from that. I run my regular classes. You can join us and learn from that as well if you want to learn this in depth, especially the people who are elder. You know, I don't teach to kids, but I do teach to the older people, elderly people. Yeah. Vanshika.
Yes, sir. My question is that if we see someone's handwriting who is better than us and we are obsessed with it and we want to write like them, but we are not able to do it. What does that mean?
Very nice. Thank you very much for asking the question. Why a person likes to copy somebody else's handwriting? The reason is, now this person is not getting the right kind of guidance in his life. So when he sees somebody else handwriting, he immediately gets impressed with that. Wow. So this is the kind of person I want to be. So that is where he will want to go and write like that. But he's not able to do it. It means what? He is still not able to achieve that mindset. Writing is a mindset. So this person is not getting enough guidance, enough support, enough awareness from his own house, own parents, own surrounding. So that is why this person is looking forward to learn it from someone else, which is a good sign. No? And that means if you are not able to do it, it means that you are still not there. But once you are able to do it, you will be able to write the way you want. Okay.
Sir, I have a question.
Who is that?
Sir, Aishan.
Yeah, Aishan.
Sir, if a person says that he has a question, then afterwards forgets it.
Don't go there. Don't go there. Yeah. Kritika, you have some question?
Okay. So, sorry, I have too many questions, but the session is interesting.
I want you all to ask a lot of questions.
Yeah. Actually, sir, as as a teacher, what I experience is students, they don't rub. I mean, if even they have done any error or mistake, they don't rub. Instead, they just scribble and they write on the top or just next to it. So, what does that mean?
Okay.
And how can we correct it?
So, when you write and when you smudge your mistake, it means you are too afraid to show your bad side, your side which is not very clean and good to other people. When you write and you just give cut like this, and then you again write as and whatever you want to, it means you are comfortable showing your mistakes to other people. You are comfortable showing your bad side to other people as well. You are not afraid that what other may think or what other may will have or what other people will judge you or not. But when you smudge, you are too afraid to show your bad side to people. You want other people to just see you as a good person. And without smudging, if you write up and down, it's like you are ready to correct yourself then and there instead of waiting for next moment. You will make sure that whatever you want to do, you will do right now. Whether you want to say sorry or whether you want to do good work and all, you will do right now. If you are trying to adjust and write something, you know, if this is bad, so this will write and B will be written over here or D will be. So this is the way the people will adjust then and there without waiting for the next moment. So this means that. Yeah. Again, Aro, I hope you have a good question.
So I want to write in good handwriting, for which I always try, but I don't know why it is not coming out.
Not coming out well because you are not patient enough. You are not taking a lot of efforts. You need to put a lot of efforts. You need to practice it, and then only it will come onto the paper. Internally, you have to be a good human being, as well as you will have to put efforts to achieve those things. Okay, it's about practice. Yeah, Arhan Jain. Arhan, unmute.
Sir, I want to ask that always I write in cursive.
Okay. Okay. It's okay, you know, whatever you write, it's okay as long as it's benefiting you. Now, Rutuja wants to ask one question. Rutuja Rahate. Chaitanya. Okay. Answer. Okay, Rutuja, please go ahead. Ask your question.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
आपका सेशन बहुत अच्छा है, आई एंजॉय अ लॉट, और बहुत इन्फॉर्मेटिव है फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. सेकंड मेरा क्वेश्चन है, मैं हिंदी और मराठी की टीचर हूँ. मोस्टली बच्चे और बड़े भी जो लेटर्स होते हैं हिंदी मराठी में, उनके ऊपर लाइन नहीं मारते जो हम लोग लाइन मारते, तो उसका क्या मतलब होता है?
अगर आप ऊपर की तरफ लाइन नहीं देते हो, हिंदी और मराठी में ऊपर का लाइन जो है, हिंदी मराठी संस्कृत ये लैंग्वेज में ऊपर का जो लाइन है वो फैमिली का सपोर्ट दर्शाता है, वो फैमिली का सपोर्ट दर्शाता है. और अगर आप ऊपर लाइन नहीं दोगे, इसका मतलब आपकी फैमिली को आपका आपको आपका फैमिली का सपोर्ट नहीं है, आपको सपोर्ट नहीं मिलता, और आपको सपोर्ट नहीं मिला हुआ है. यू आर नॉट गेटिंग द सपोर्ट फ्रॉम द फैमिली, यू आर नॉट गॉट इट फ्रॉम द फैमिली, यू आर नॉट गेटिंग इट फ्रॉम द मीनिंग ऑफ नॉट गिविंग द लाइन का मतलब वो होता है. अगर बच्चे कर रहे हो ऐसा लाइन, इसका मतलब उनके फैमिली का सपोर्ट उनको नहीं मिल रहा है. और अगर किड्स कर बड़े कर रहे तो उनको नहीं मिला था और अभी भी नहीं मिल रहा है. ठीक है, गुड क्वेश्चन. एनीवन एल्स? एनी एल्डर पीपल? नो पीपल, यू नो द पीपल हु आर बिट ओल्डर इन एज, नॉट विद द माइंड बट विद द एज. वंस देयर आर क्वेश्चंस आस्क्ड. ठीक है, सो द लास्ट 7 मिनट्स ऑफ द सेशन, ask something which will be beneficial for all of us. Yeah, it will, Angaji. What your agent calculus? Yes, we can detect that very very easily. Ravi Shankar has some kind of question. Nawal Khan.
Whenever my grandmother teaches me and she tells that I'll write and then you copy it so you can understand it. So whenever she writes, I never understand what she has written. I ask her every time.
So she is very intelligent, no? Your grandmother is very intelligent. She's a fast thinker, right? Very true. Very intelligent, very fast thinker. Yes. And she might be reading a lot. She might be having this reading habit.
She is reading a book
this
time now.
Yeah, so that is what it means. Okay, yeah. Nawal Khan, go ahead. Please ask question.
Sir, I wanted to ask, now like the kids are growing, so is there any kind of a book or, you know, any probably, or do we have to do your course so that we can teach them the perfect or the right or maybe the correct way of learning how to write so that they can be a better person in the future?
Thank you very much for asking this question. I was waiting for this question, you know. Her question is, can I make my kids write in particular way so that they will be better human beings in the future? Oh, so the answer is no.
Oh.
You can make your kids better human being by improving yourself. Because ultimately they are going to get influenced by whom? They are going to get influenced by you, their parents, their mother, father, grandmother, grandfather, surrounding, kids, friends, you know. So they will be getting influenced by them all the way. So the right thing for you is to influence them by your behavior, by your actions. By just, even if you change their handwriting today, tomorrow it will change again. The moment you are not looking into the handwriting, it will change. Even your handwriting is changing every single day, right? It's not the same the way it was 10 years back. So it is going to change all the time. So the right way of programming your kids is improve your own thing, improve your own self, improve your own way of, you know, doing things. Work on yourself. After 14 years of age, remember this, after 14 years of age, then you introduce this science to them so that they will choose how they want to be and they will improve their handwriting. Right now, till the 14 years of age, their subconscious mind is like empty vessel. Whatever they see is going to get inside their vessel. So this is not the right age to do it. But after 14, they must undergo this course to improve the handwriting.
All right. Thank you so much. That was very informative.
Yeah, thank you. But you can focus on this small aspect, which I told you. For example, giving the underscore or giving the proper horizontal line to every other letter, especially T. You know, these are small. Writing with the clarity, writing readable, legible things. These are small things for which you don't need any graphologist to look into your handwriting, right? So with this kind of thing, you can manage your kid a bit better compared to other people. Yeah. So Shreyash, I'm going to unmute you. Shriyan.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, on Hindi, I put a line on top from right to left.
I'm a lefty.
Because I'm a lefty.
It means that you have reverse way of thinking. It means that whenever you say yes, after some time you also say no. So you have tendency to go back from your commitments. So whether you are lefty or righty, doesn't matter. The directions are same for universe. So it's better if you do the signature from right to the line from right to left. When you do right to left, it is the right way of doing the things. If you do from right to left, it means what have you understood about going back to the origin, going back from the commitment, saying yes and after that saying no. All those things will start happening with you. Okay. So left to right is a commitment. Right to left is going back from the commitments. Okay.
Sure.
So your family also does same, because now you are at the top of the line, you are doing this. It means your family goes back from their commitment. They say that they will do something for you, and later they say, Shayanj, abhi time nahi hai, abhi nahi karenge. You know? Yeah. Okay. Then Vandana Rao. Vandana Mishra, sorry. Vandana Mishra, yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, sir, it's better to write your signature in the initials like V.S. Mishra, or it has to be Vandana S. Mishra. What is a correct way of signing any document or normal checks and all?
See, it depends on your profession and the achievements you want to do. If you are an actor, I will always ask you to write your full name, because writing full name will give you better chance to succeed as an actor. If you are talking about your own life, then I need to understand what your life is like. What kind of challenges you face, what kind of achievement
you have. Sir, I am a lawyer.
Yeah, I understand that. But right now, within 2 minutes, I won't be able to understand your full life, right?
Okay.
It will take minimum 40 to 45 minutes to understand your life and then come to conclusion about what exactly your sign should be. So it is going to take time. So this is supposed to be a private consultation.
It depends on person to person as to what will be an ideal signature for you.
Yeah, right. Very correct. That is why Shahrukh is successful with the signature of Shahrukh. Tendulkar is successful with the Tendulkar of Tendulkar. You know, everybody has a different way of getting success. So you need to understand the background, the profession, the scenario, the strength and the weaknesses, and along the way you can form the signature. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Now somebody is asking why use black pen. No, never use black pen as a kid. Black pen makes you very, very rigid. Black pen makes you non-agile. Black pen makes you very, what you can say, no? Very aloof in nature. So as a kids, I will never suggest you to go for black. But once you become any authority, like if you are a judge, you should use a black pen. If you are a bouncer, you should use a black pen. If you are a lawyer, you can use a black pen. If you are a doctor, you can use a black pen, because you will be an authority in that field. But if you are not authority in that field, don't use black pens. Okay. Yeah. Okay, that's it. So if Mrs. Noreena Fernandez is there, we can end the session. It's 3 o'clock already. And I don't know.
So I can come, sir. I'm there. I've been listening to all the questions, and I can just assure you that they're very intelligent questions, and it's come with a lot of innocence from the kids, and of course some questions from the parents, which is of course their professional lives. And I think even the teacher had the concern of Hindi and Marathi teacher, and I think it was a very interactive and a very nice session. But I think you must give the parents a little assurance that they can learn something more from you, and they can teach the children. Because if I had a child who was that young, I would have loved to teach them, you know, a little more, scale it up, and maybe have a session only for our Mira Road parents, you know, scale it up for them typically. So the session that we have today is to for our children to understand how important the handwritings are. Because nowadays children are not used to writing, not my children, not at PIS Mira Road, but otherwise, and especially more in my observation as a principal, that very intelligent students don't want to write. They go more on oral. And I understand exactly where it comes from. So if you could give some kind of an assurance to the parents, maybe not immediately, but maybe a little later, because as a parent, I want to scale up the capabilities of my child. We're all working towards one goal. And why not give that confidence from the very fact that, you know, putting the letters together in the alphabet or in the family name, give that kind of an assurance to all of them. So those who are interested would be should at least be able to see you how Mrs. Mishra wanted to know so many things, so many questions bothering. And they're going to go back with those questions unless you give them some kind of an assurance.
Correct.
So I think let them take it if they want to, because all of us want to succeed at the end of the day. I could send you my signature, and I would want to know, even though I know for myself what I am and what my constitution and what my powers are, but I would still want to hear it from Sudhir Kobi.
Correct. So thank you very much for putting the light on this. I just forgot to mention this, that, okay, if you want to really take advantage of this knowledge, as a parent, you must learn this. Now, what is the advantage of you learning this science? Because you know how your kids are getting programmed by your behavior. Now, after learning this science, you will be knowing how to behave with kids, so that your kids become more powerful in nature. Instead of working on kids, you need to work on your own behavior, your own way of interacting with the kid. And that knowledge you will be getting through this handwriting analysis and signature analysis program. So this program will be for you all who are parents, because kids will be changing all the time. So if you have this knowing, you will be able to change their writing. You will be at every step, whenever they change the handwriting again, you will be making them aware, okay, this is not the way to do it, this is the way to do it, and what is the reason behind it as well.